Hi, I'm Jose Saldana, and I look a little tired because I'm on baby duty tonight. This is my daily devotion. We're looking at Proverbs chapter 21 and verse number 2, how to avoid poor decisions. In Proverbs chapter 21 and verse number 2, the Bible says, "Every man's way is right in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs and examines the hearts, the people, and their motives." There is so much maturity in being able to admit that you really don't know it all. It takes a big person to be able to say, "Yeah, I don't really quite have it all together as of yet, right now." It stems from a root of pride to feel that your opinions are the absolute right way to do everything. When you feel that you are right all the time, that comes from pride. So to be able to move away from the point of believing our own opinion to be the absolute truth is a move towards humility. The more that you move from feeling that your position is always right, your point of view is always correct, when you move away from maybe I'm not always right, that's a move towards humility. This is the direction God would have us to move towards humility. When it comes to our walk with God or the status of our pending salvation, it is easy for every person to try to justify our thoughts and our actions and our words. If we get angry and mercilessly offend somebody without regard for human life, we can justify our own way and be right in our own eyes. I'm okay to say the things that I said and treat people the way that I treat them because I am me and right in my own eyes. If we fall into temptation to compromise the gospel or compromise our stance or our convictions, again, this is a place many have justified their actions and made themselves right in their own eyes. The Lord weighs the hearts. He examines the motives and the intentions behind our actions. He understands if we make arguments and lie to ourselves, claiming to please him when we really know we're out just to please ourselves, he knows when we're doing that. You know what? Friends, a real true friend is more than able to tell you the same thing. A friend indeed can tell you when you're being selfish and justifying yourself. If you are being selfless and allowing God to justify you, they can tell that too. Don't be afraid to ask a trusted friend for advice when you are unsure of your own motives and your own actions. When I say trusted friend, I mean, of course, a person of conviction, a God-fearing, Holy Ghost-filled person. Don't go asking the world for spiritual advice. Don't go asking the world what your next steps ought to be if the matter is already clarified for you in the Word of God. And don't just ask one person for advice. Ask plenty of people. Ask your pastor. Ask people that are wise and have experiences that you trust. Ask wise, faithful, trustworthy people with a good track record. Three times in the book of Proverbs alone, the benefits of having a number of people to counsel with and talk to is written out for us. In Proverbs chapter 11 and verse 14, "Where no counsel is, the people fall. But in the multitude of counselors, there is safety." Proverbs chapter 15 and verse 22, "Without counsel, purposes are disappointed. But in the multitude of counselors, they are established." Proverbs chapter 24 and verse 6, "For by wise counsel thou shalt make thy war, and in multitude of counselors there is safety." The Word of God, God Himself, God-breathed Word, says ask a lot of people for advice. Go to people, get counsel from people, get input from their experiences and what and glean from their wisdom. Seek out the most successful people you can in your particular field, subject, situation. Glean from them every bit of wisdom that you can. And this is how you can avoid making poor decisions.